Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
So, welcome guys. Welcome for today's class after a long break, I think. So today we will see like what Hadoop commands are about, how to copy some files from our local file system to HDFS, and the same way how to copy from HDFS to local, how to create a directory and all those things, and few other programs as well, right? So in our previous class we have discussed like what are the different ways that we can interact with HDFS, right? So there are three different ways. To interact with HDFS. So the first one is command line interface, and the next one is Java API. And the next one is browser interface, but still, sorry, web interface, still this is used only for browse. Here we will not be able to create any file or any directory directly through the web interface. This is only used for view purpose only. So but still this is the most easier way to view any of our files, right? Instead of giving some commands on our terminal and doing all those things, it's always easier to have a interface, web interface, which will be easily understandable by everyone, right? And the next one is So along with these things we have few other tools as well, right? So we can load the data through Scoop or Flume. So we all very well know about Flume and Scoop, but still we are going to discuss in our later sessions. But for right now, on a high level, on a topmost view, Scoop is used to load the data from our databases. So we have our traditional databases, right? Maybe our SQL database or Oracle database, maybe our PLSQL database or something like that. So from those databases I can load data from, we can load the data from those databases to our Hadoop file system. So Scoop is used to load the data which is in a structured format. So for example, if you take our Oracle database, there will be lot many tables and we will have rows and columns and there will be some referential constraints and all other things as well, right? So for that reason Scoop is used to load those kind of data. And coming to Flume, Flume mostly handles unstructured data, maybe our blogs or images, whatever the data which is not in a most readable format. So we will be generating some logs and all those things for unstructured data, right? So those logs can be loaded into HDFS through Flume. So anyways, we will discuss Flume and Scoop at the end of our sessions on how to load and all those things. But right now, we will majorly concentrate on command line interface and Java API. Okay, fine. Okay, so for that, let me enter into my VMware so that I can try running few commands today. And maybe you can practice very well. at your home. So is everyone able to install Hadoop on their systems? Okay, that's great, Rahul. So guys, just follow the document and you should be able to install it, but still don't panic if you are not able to install. Or don't worry, just have a Google browse of your problems and maybe whenever I am available, I will help you guys. Of course, installing Hadoop is a very tedious thing, I know. I do understand. Okay. So we all were aware of these commands, right? Okay. Yeah, hi Sneha, hi. Okay, thanks for joining. So everything is running up. Let me log into my user interface as well. So something is happening here. Oh, I'm not able to view commands. Okay, so my name node is up and everything is fine right now. So let's see few commands today. So probably we will finish our HDFS sessions today and from our next session onwards we can start working on MapReduce. Okay guys. So this is the first command in our HDFS. So it is called as mkdir. The usage of mkdir is it is used to create any directory. So if at all I want to create some file in my Hadoop directory, I can do it using mkdir command. So let's try with the command here. maybe training is already there, so let me go with training 1. Okay, so I'm trying to create a directory at user Hadoop inst Hadoop 1.0.3. So let's see through our interface whether we are not able to create the directory or not. So this is the place where we can check all our files that have been created till now. So if I click on browse file system, I will be able to see all the directories and all the paths as well. So now I had created it at user, right? So Hadoop inst Hadoop 1.0.3, and here I had created a directory called as training 1. So this directory doesn't have any files right now, and so it is empty. So this is how I create a command. So if I want to create more than one directory, I can follow the same using the above one. Hadoop fs make directory path 1, path 2, path 3, and so on. So at the same time, I can create number of directories as well. So I would suggest that if you want to execute any of your MapReduce programs, then it's better you create a directory and copy all the files that required for your inputs and create at the same area your output files as well, such that all the files related to a particular program will be in a separate directory, and it will be useful for you in your next sessions as well, in your next trainings also. So the next command is write files from HDFS to local file system. So this command is used to write a file from our local file system to our HDFS. So once you install our operating system Linux, definitely we will have our local file system, right? So on top of that, we are installing Hadoop, and by default, once we install Hadoop, we will get HDFS as well, right? Which is a new file system. So totally there will be two file systems. One is the local file system, and on top of it there will be HDFS, which is Hadoop distributed file system. So what I'm trying to do right now is I'm trying to copy a file from my local file system to HDFS. So the command that is used to do this is Hadoop fs copy from local my input path and then my output path. So here I am trying to copy a file called as program2. So this program2 is available at this place, home Gita programs. So let's see whether it's available there. Home Gita programs PGM1. So this is what I have in my PGM1. This is the first program in Hadoop. This is copy from local to HDFS, right? So let's execute this command in our terminal. So but still I'm doing it in training 1, as we already have a training folder. So now let's browse our file system. So now I had this program 2 into my training 1 directory. So let's see and open. This is the first program in Hadoop. This is the copy from local to HDFS. Right guys? So this is what I have in my local file system as well. So that means this file have been copied to my HDFS in order to perform, if at all I need to perform any operation on it. Yes, Sneha, I do understand your problem, but still, I mean, definitely you can go through all the recordings, and I'm sure that you will be able to understand all the things. Till now we had around 6 to 7 classes, I think. I don't remember exactly, but still you will get all the PPTs and recordings for them. And I could say like most of the things we have covered till now is theoretical. From today onwards we have started hands-on. And still also the today's hands-on session is a very smaller session. It's like the basic commands which we can play with our HDFS. But from tomorrow, in the sense from the next session onward, we can start discussing on MapReduce, which is the core heart of our Hadoop course. So don't worry about these things. everything is going to set right, maybe in 1 or 2 days. Don't worry about all those things. Okay. Okay. I'm not sure about that, Sneha. Maybe you can talk with the organizer on that. Yeah, definitely he will help you. And he will share you all the PPTs also. And guys, don't worry or don't confuse while opening these documents. The password to open all these documents is H2K. So I had kept a default password called as H2K to open any of the PPTs. Okay, so, I think few people have problem opening these PPTs. So that's the reason I am telling you. Okay. Okay guys, fine. Okay. Fine. Akshay has a problem stating that he is not able to view name note. Maybe Akshay, I think you have to format your name note. Maybe you missed that step and that should help and you should be able to see your name note available. And also guys, make sure that all your 3 sites were perfect. If there is any problem in any of your sites, then I'm not sure that how you are going to set up your cluster, okay? So maybe I will share those 3 sites as well to you so that you can just have a quick check whether you have the same things as well. Yes. Okay. Okay, fine guys. Okay, so, and also guys, remember, like, whenever you have a command like this, in Linux file systems, we have a procedure while writing a command. Always, the first word will start with a small letter. So, if you see here, in copy, I have C as a small. And also, the next words that have been followed with this copy, everything starts with a capital letter. So in from I have FS capital and in local I have LS capital. So this is what we follow for all the commands that we give in Hadoop file system. And also all the commands will start with Hadoop FS. So whenever you want to interact with Hadoop file system, definitely you have to give Hadoop FS and then only after your particular command what you want to do. So the command wholly says as Hadoop FS copy from local input path of your local file system and then the output path of your HDFS. So along with this we have one more command called as put command. This put command is also used for the same purpose. So again the format would be Hadoop FS put local file system path and then again Hadoop file system path. Okay, so let's move to our next command which is read files from HDFS. So most of the times you may be in a situation like you want to know what all files that were available in a particular directory. As this is a new directory which we had created, we all know like what files we have in our training one directory. But maybe sometimes maybe some other user may log in and someone wants to look at some of the directories that were already available in my Hadoop file system. So at this time, the command which helps for me is Hadoop LS. So if at all I give the command Hadoop FS LS and then the path of the directory which I want to check, it will give all the list of files that were available in training 1. So, if you are able to see this, here it is showing you all the properties of this file, program 2. So, it is saying that program 2 is a file that is available in training 1 directory, the path which I had given in my command. And it has been created today at this time. And the permissions that I have on it is read-write permissions and also it is showing you like who is the owner and who is the supergroup and all those details as well. So the same thing you can see it here as well. So the type of information that I had copied into my HDFS is a file which is named as program 2, and the size of my file is 0.7 KB, and the replication factor is 1. And still now this replication factor is a configurable thing which I can give, right? So I had given replication factor as 1 somewhere, and that's the reason it is showing as 1. If at all I declare it as 2 or 3, definitely it will show you as replication factor as 2 or 3. And guys, by the way, can anyone tell me like where I will declare this replication factor? There is one particular site in our Hadoop file system which will have this replication factor, right? Can anyone give a guess on it? Core? No. No, Akshay, it's not core. It's not MapRed. Yes, it is HDFS, right? So the replication and data management, everything is related to our HDFS, right? So definitely these configurations will be available in our HDFS site.xml. So if you go through your HDFS site.xml that was available in your conf directory, you will be able to see our replication factor which is declared as 1 over there, right? Okay. And the next one is block size. So it is telling as my block size, my default block size is 64 MB. So I haven't declared my block size anywhere, and so that's the reason it is taking the default size as 64 MB. So that's what guys, some of the properties of a particular file once it got created into our HDFS. So let's go to the next command, which is copy files from HDFS to local file system. So if you observe, this is just a reverse command of copy from local, right? So this command will have as copy to local. So it will copy all the files or any particular files that is available in our HDFS to local file system. So the command used for this is hadoopfs copy to local my HDFS path and then my local path. So let's try running this command. I think test is already available over there. So let me give a new one. Test one. Okay. So I'm trying to copy this program 2. So I have program 2 created in my training 1 directory. So I'm trying to copy this program 2 file to my local file system to test 1, right? So let's see whether it has been created. So if you see here, I have copied this. And I have test 1 as, this is the first program in Hadoop, this is copy from local to HDFS. So this is how you copy the files. The same command can also be done again with get command. So it's like a reverse command of put command. So the format you are going to use is hadoopfs get your Hadoop file system path and then your local file system path. So if you observe this, we have two major commands, right? Copy from local, which is also a put command. And the next one is so it's up to us if at all I want to use copy from local or put, and copy to local or get. have a question. Let me see. Yes, Neha. Yeah, I do understand that it's like a bit confusing factor for you, but still I suggest you to hold on for one more class so that you will be able to understand. Maybe you can check with the organizer. He will share you all the links for the PPTs and all those things. You can go from them. I mean, I just wanted to convey you, like, we haven't did any rocket science till now. So it's all about the basics which we understand. Yeah. Yes, I got your points, Neha, yeah. But still don't worry. I mean, as you are already aware of basic Java and all those things, I think it shouldn't give any problem for you. I mean, a basic core knowledge about Java will help you a lot in understanding the things much more easier and faster way. So only thing that you have to concentrate is a bit command on Linux. Okay, so that should help you. Don't worry or don't get. But I suggest you to just go through this class and try to understand or try to dig whatever things you will able to understand and just keep it aside. And once you, before you start doing all these things, just go through the PPTs and recordings. All the recordings I am going to share it today. So probably you can go through them so that you will be much more in a better shape. Okay. So guys, let's see the next command which we have, which is deleting a file or directory from HDFS. So I had created a directory in my HDFS and I want to delete it at particular moment. I don't need it and it's using so much of space. Okay, at that moment I will feel like deleting that particular directory. So for that, the command used is Hadoop fs rmr user Hadoop inst. So this is the path whatever that I want to delete it. So let's see whether we have this at all. First of all, so or else, okay, I have program 2 in my training directory. Let's delete this file. Okay, and one more thing guys, here the control C and control V will not work. Every time you have to copy it and you have to right click it to paste that. So control C and V is not going to work here. Training program 2. So I'm trying to delete program 2 file from my training directory. So it is saying as deleted HDFS and then my path. So let's see whether it is available or not right now. So I have the training directory, but still the directory is empty, right? So this file have been deleted from my training directory. So the same way I can delete directories as well. So if at all I give Hadoop fs rmr user Hadoop inst Hadoop 1.0.3 and then I end up with training, the whole directory will get deleted. So be careful before you delete any of your files. Just directly, don't directly give the directory names. It may cause you some problems sometimes. And the next one is safe mode. So sometimes if you log in, you will see, if you log in and once you open your web interface, you will see like safe mode is on and it is going to be restored maybe in 10 seconds or 5 seconds or 20 seconds. Or maybe sometimes you have to leave your safe mode manually as well. So that will happen sometimes whether you, if your data node is not able to talk with your name node properly, or maybe you shut down your virtual machine or you are out of your Hadoop file system wrongly, directly, bluntly, if you close it without closing all your processes and all those things, sometimes it will go to safe mode. Means it's like you will not be able to create any file or delete any file from your HDFS. Probably you will be able to browse your file system, but still you will not be able to create or do any operations on your HDFS. So at that moment you have to give the command hadoopfs safe mode leave. So this will make your HDFS come out of safe mode. Guys, don't get panicked that if you are not able to execute this command. Maybe sometimes it will say you like permission denied and you will not be able to do that. At that moment just give the command hadoopfs admin safe mode leave. So if you give the command admin, it will give you the admin permissions to execute this command. So that should help you. Any of this command should help you to come out of safe mode, and probably most of the times you will come to face this problem. So I'm not going to run this command right now because my Hadoop cluster is fine and it is up and running properly now. So this command will not work for me right now. So, and the next one is Hadoop fsck user Hadoop inst and then the files. So these three commands we have already tested, right? So fsck is like which will give you all the list of files that were available in that particular directory. So if I give this fsck user Hadoop inst Hadoop 1.0.3 files, it will show you all the files that were available in Hadoop 1.0.3 directory. So it will be very huge and it's going to be take some time as well if I run this command as well. And the next one is report and refresh nodes. So I'm not going to discuss about these things because we already discussed on report and refresh nodes. So whenever a new data node have been added, if you give this command refresh nodes, it will get reflected on your web interface as well as on the terminal. So these are few commands that can be executed through our terminal. So this is one way, right? This is command line interface. And the next one is through our Java API. So I can execute or I can do the same operations by writing a Java program as well. So it's up to me to decide whether I want to write a new Java program or I want to do it through the terminal itself. So but if you ask me or if you ask me to say something or suggest me something, I would tell you like just follow the commands because that's the most easiest way. People will look for the most easiest way to finish their tasks, right? So if at all if it's just a requirement of copying a files from our local file system to then Hadoop file system, then use the commands instead of Java programs. But if you want to do some analysis or if you want to generate some reports, then go for Java programs. That's the best way and that's the only way do the analysis. So before you write your Java programs, there should be some editor for that, right? So the editor which we are going to use right now is Eclipse. So guys, you can directly Google it and type it as Eclipse standard Kepler for a 64-bit machine. If at all your machine is a 64 machine, or download Eclipse standard Kepler for a 32-bit machine. There you will get some tar.gz files. So download the tar.gz file and unzip it and install Eclipse. So we have already Eclipse installed on our system and just I'm trying to open that. So I have written three programs here, copy program and then a create program and then a read program. So what this HDFS copy a program will do is it's going to copy a file from my local file system to HDFS. So if I go through command line interface, it is just copy from local. But if I go through a Java program, it is some sort of commands, some sort of statements that you have to give it here. So if at all you want to write any program, just go to file and then new, and then it's a Java project, right? So create a Java project, maybe H2K1, finish. So I had created a new Java project, and then I need to have a editor to write my class, right? So go to new and then class. So by default class 1 I am giving. Okay, so once you created a class, by default you are getting a package and then a public class. So but still it's up to you if you want to have the setting or not. I mean, you can create a class with an empty file, or maybe by default you can have this package and public class loaded in it. Okay, so once you come to this place, copy your program. And don't worry guys, I will share you all these programs as well, so that you can try it at your homes once you install your clusters. And there are few libraries that I have to import. So if you see the libraries here, I have few Java libraries and then few libraries that were particular to Hadoop. So all the libraries related to Hadoop will start with import org.apache.hadoop. So I have few configuration libraries, buffered FS input stream, data input stream, output stream, and few other things as well. And guys, don't worry about these libraries. It's by default you have all these libraries in all your programs. So if at all you want to know like what is this buffered input stream, you just go to Google and click it. It will show you like what is the interface from with Java class you are getting this buffered input stream, and what this function is going to, what is the functionality of this particular command. So if you observe this program, the first command I'm having is public class where my program starts, and then I had having a main class where I will write my whole program. So the first command which here is configuration. So this command will create an object called as conf, which will import all my configuration properties into this Java program. So we had given all the configurations in three sites, right? Core site, MapRed, and HDFS sites, right? So I have to use all those properties in my Java program. So in order to use those properties, I am giving this command called as configuration conf is equal to new of configuration. And then there is a step called as URI. So what this URI command gives is, it will tell you that which local host I am connecting to. So if you remember, I had given this local host somewhere in our configuration sites, right? Can anyone guess that? Right. Right, perfect. So it is coresite.xml where I will give my local host address, right? So this is the same address. If you see here also, okay, once you just open your browser mode, it will show you like name node is connected to localhost 54310. Okay, so as I'm into that paths, I'm not able to see that. But once if you install your browser mode, maybe in the next class I will show you that it will highlight. I mean, in the previous class I had shown you, right? It will highlight as Hadoop localhost. And the next one is input stream is equal to input stream new buffered input stream. So it is reading your input stream that was given in your local path, which is home Gita programs w count. So it is reading all the text or messages that were written in w count file. So for that I am using an buffered input stream. So buffered input stream is like a class which is used to read data from my input stream. And the next one is, I have to connect with my file system to talk anything with my HDFS. So for that, I'm creating an object called as file system for my file system, and I am getting both the URI and my configuration properties. And the next command is output stream, where I am giving my target path. So my target path is HDFS path, right? So here I am giving it as HDFS localhost user Hadoop inst Hadoop 1.0.3 and then WC count. So once I execute this program, there will be a file that will get created called as WC input into this particular path. So probably I will have that. Let me delete it once. Or else let me do one thing. So I'm just deleting this command before I execute that. If at all you have this file already available, it will throw an error stating that file already exists. So at that time you have to delete that file, or maybe you can give a new name so that it will doesn't give any conflicts. Okay, so I'm deleting this file right now. So okay, successful, deleted that particular file. So I shouldn't be able to see that. So okay, fine, well and good, I don't have that file. So, and the next step is progress. So it will just, I mean, progress is just a function which is which tells you whether it's going to be progressed or not while executing your program. And then this try command is just it's copying the bytes from my input stream to output stream, and finally once everything has been copied, I'm closing by stream. So that's what pretty much about this command. And before you run this command, get all your libraries imported. Okay, this is important thing. So all the common libraries that you have to import here is these things. Maybe you can use this recording to import all these things, but if at all you want to import any library here, just go to build path, configure build path, and then go to libraries, add external jars, and then select all these things till here, and then just click on OK such that it will get imported into your under your reference libraries. Okay, so I'm not doing it right now because I have it already. Okay, but before you run your command, just import all these libraries into your any of your Java programs. Maybe in your MapReduce also you are going to write some programs, right? At that moment as well you have to import all these libraries, or else you will get it will throw some errors. So let's try running this. So first of all, if I want to run this program, I have to export my jar file, right? So for that, I am giving a right click on my HDFS copy, give the export, and then select the jar file which that needs to be exported, and then give a next, HDFS copy A. So here is the jar file name that I am giving. So it is same as my class name as well. So maybe you can give your own jar name as well. It's not mandated that it should be same as your class name. And then go to next. And again next. Now select the class for which you are creating the jar. So this is my class name, right? HDFS for PA. Give OK on this. And then finish. Okay. So now I am ready to run it on my terminal, right? So the command that is used to run a particular jar file is Hadoop, jar, jar name, and then class name. So here I have to give it as Hadoop jar. What is my jar name? HDFS copy A dot jar, and then my class name. Right? So this I can directly give it over there. So the command has been executed now. Now I am able to see my WC input, right? So it has been created and the size of this file is 0.2 KB and everything is same again, replication factor and box size. It has given the modification date and time. Let's open and see this file whether the same contents have been copied or not. This is a sample word count program, which is the first program in this tutorial. It counts the number of words, etc., etc., etc. Okay, so let's go to our input path. So what we had given in my program is home Geeta programs WC count. So this is what I have in my W count in my local file system, right? So it is very well same. It is very well same with my HDFS, right? So this is the same word count and everything is same. So this is how you go with a Java program. So let's see, we have a question here. Most of the times the best suggested way is go through command prompt itself, because for a single execution to occur, do I actually need to write a very huge Java program like this just to copy a single file? Do I need to write all these things? No, right? It's not suggestible. You have this way, but it is not suggestible, right? I am just trying to show you what all different ways we have to copy a file or to do a particular operation. One more, we have a question. Yeah, there is no particular setup to install all these things. I mean, just go and download Eclipse, so that would be sufficient for you to interact with HDFS. Just download Eclipse and, as I showed you, create a path where such that you can write your program. Maybe if you had seen here, right, I had created a project and then I had created a class such that I can write my program here. So once it is done, just export your jar file and directly you can run your jar file in your terminal with the above command: Hadoop jar, jar name, and then class name. That will suffice our requirements. The same way, I have few other programs as well. So this is same as my mkdir command. So mkdir command will create a directory in my HDFS at a particular path, right? So for the same thing, I had a Java program which is creating a directory. So I am creating a directory test2 at my user location. So guys, you can very well practice all these things. I will share you these programs. So again, importing and everything will be same. You can have all the files in common for all your programs. So as I told you, these steps are very common, right? For all the things, the configuration, URI, and file system. So all these are common. So only thing that will change is like whatever you want to do. If it's a copy from local, you will have the input and output paths. If it's a make directory, you will have just a make directory command with my file system. That's it. And then it will This program will show you or read a particular path. Here I had given a path called as Hadoop inst Hadoop 1.0.3 customers. So if I run this command in my terminal, it will show you all the contents that were available in my customers file. So have a customers file here, right? So it contains some information. So all this information will be displayed on my terminal. So that's it. So the same command to read is ls, right? Hadoop fs ls. So if I give the command Hadoop fs ls user Hadoop inst Hadoop 1.0.3 customers, it will show you the same thing. So this is another way of getting that information. Okay, so that's what pretty much about today's class, guys. Just let me know if you have any questions on this. Yeah, okay. So some of the guys are requesting to share that all the three sites .xmls so that they can just have a quick compare of that. Yeah, sure. Definitely I will share you those three XML files as well. Yeah. Masters and slaves. Guys, you don't need to edit your master or slave files because we are installing Hadoop in a pseudo distributed mode, right? So my master is the same system and slave is also a same system, right? So the default configuration will suffice you. If at all you are going to install your Hadoop in a distributed mode, then only you will give all the IPs of other machines in your different sites and the setup will be quite different from the document which I had shared with you. Okay, so this document is used to install Hadoop only in pseudo distributed mode. Yes, and the masters and slaves will be empty. Okay. So someone wants to see what is there. Okay. Okay, one second, let me log in. So in my core site, right? Okay. Right, this is what you have in the coresite.xml. Okay. You want to see this app Hadoop temp. Okay, let me go into this. So okay, you have the DFS and MapRed. So these two files or these two directories are important and mandatory as well. Okay, you should be able to see all these two directories. If at all you are not able to see any one of them, means you had missed out some step or maybe you had given some wrong command while installing. So just have a quick check on what the things you had done. Yes. So in my MapRed, you should have it as local. Yes, yes, no problem. You can have a check on it. Right. Well, you can see this masters and slaves. They should be empty. Maybe you can try with giving that SSH command to test whether you are able to connect to your localhost and all those things as well. Once if you are confirmed about those things, then the masters and slaves is not, it is not required to disturb those two directories. The only three things that you have to touch it is coresite.xml, MapRed and hdfssite.xml. Along with that, you have Hadoop environment.sh and bashrc files. Those two needs to have your Java. Java path, right? Yes. So that's what you have to touch. Okay. Yeah, you can try it. No problem. Yeah. Fine. Okay. Okay, any other questions, guys, before we wrap up for today? Okay. Fine. Okay, tomorrow we are not going to have the class because tomorrow I'm having a client visit and I have to leave my office very early. So probably I will not be able to come to tomorrow's session. Day after tomorrow at the same time, you can use the same link. Maybe that day we can have maybe 1.5 session or something like that, like today, so that we can cover some more topics. Yes. Yes. So from day after tomorrow, it is important for you guys to understand all the things. We are at the core heart of our Hadoop systems from day after tomorrow, which is MapReduce. Yes. Okay, guys. And do remember, you stop your cluster before you are quitting out or shutting down your VMware. Okay, or else it will throw some errors. Yes. Okay, guys. Thank you all for joining today's session. Yes. We will meet day after tomorrow at the same time. Good night, guys. Yes, bye.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.